of Revelation chapter 1:18, he says, I have the keys of death and hell with me. I hold the keys of death and hell with me. It is me. I have the right to decide whom should be saved and whom should not be saved.
The word declares that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven, on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess. Every tongue should confess on earth and under the earth and in heaven that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Holy Spirit, you are the finger of God. I ask you to keep your hands on me and fill me with your love, with the holiness, and with your power. Now this anointing is coming for you all over the world. Bear it in Jesus.
To you, I declare that you are my Lord and my God. You are my Savior and my Redeemer. I love you, Jesus. I love you from my heart, from the bottom of my heart. I love you, Jesus, because you are my God and my Lord. You have redeemed my life. You have saved my life. Oh, Jesus, my Lord. My God, I worship you, I adore you, I glorify your mighty name. I believe and proclaim that the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the name above all names. And that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every knee should bow in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God. I declare it to my Father in heaven. Jesus, my Savior. I believe it and I proclaim it. That the name of Jesus is the name above all names. The word declares in the book of Philippians 2, 10 and 11. The word declares. That the name of Jesus is the name above all names. The name of Jesus is the name above all names. And at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. And every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God. Amen. 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 Say loudly, Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 How many of you are here for the first time for this program? Okay. Many of you are here for the first time. I ask you one question. Please don't feel bad. Why are you here? You came to see something? This is miracles in rosary. Do you expect a miracle in your life? Do you expect some blessings from the Lord? Whatever the intentions you have in your mind, I'd like to tell you, you are here to receive the blessings from heaven through Mother Mary. Hallelujah. I promise you, if you give yourself completely to the Lord, before you leave this place, you will testify that you are blessed. That is the guarantee that I can give to you. Just listen carefully. Open your ears. Receive the word in your heart. Allow the Lord Jesus Christ to come into your heart through the word. And again, I like to tell you that you are here for some miracles in your life. You expect a miracle in your life? You have many needs in your life. I know that many of you are praying
for the last many years to solve many problems in your life. I ask you to expect anything in your life. It is not a guarantee a human being. It's a guarantee from heaven. Because this service is to glorify Mother Mary. That is why I'm telling you, whatever you expect, you will get it. When you expect a miracle, you have to make sure that Mother Mary is there in your life. I promised yesterday when we came here, not here in our Marian Center, yesterday night after reaching Goa, we gathered together and prayed together in the Marian Center. And while we were praying there, I saw Mother Mary appeared there. I saw Mother Mary standing in the midst of that group. She just came, I saw her, then she disappeared. This is happening in my life many times. I'm seeing Mother Mary in my life every day, I can tell you like that. This is my 25th year with the Lord in preaching the word. And all over my life, it was Mother Mary who supported me, who helped me to grow in the spirit. And I have seen the miracles through Mary in my life and the life of many others. Actually, it is the Holy Spirit who is going to do perform all the miracles in your life. It is the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit will ask us to make sure that the presence of Mother Mary is there in your life. How can we make sure the presence of Mary in our life? I know that you, all of you, are loving Mother Mary and you are praying to Mother Mary. I know that. But one thing, one question I like to ask you, is Mother Mary dwells in you? Is she abiding in you, in your heart? Is she there in your life? In all your needs, you are going to Mother Mary, you are praying to Mary, you are putting the flowers and lighting the candles. You do this normally. But one thing I am asking you, is Mary there in your life, in your heart? Let us come to this word, book of John chapter 2, verse 1 onwards. It is about the wedding at Cana. On the third day there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were six stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with the water," and they filled them up to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." This is what we read about the wedding at Cana. Here the word says that Mother of Jesus was there. While this wedding feast was going on, Mother of Jesus was there. Why she was there? But just we read that the Mother of Jesus was there, but Jesus was invited. The reason is that family had a close relationship with the Mother Mary. I believe so. That is why Mother Mary reached there earlier. But Jesus and his disciples were invited for the wedding. That is why they were here. But Mother Mary, she was there, she reached there earlier because of her personal fellowship, personal relationship with her family. And she came to know that now the problem that the family faced, there is no wine. She saw the trouble there. She saw the pain of their family members. Why did Mary came to Jesus? She rushed to Jesus. The reason is that The Holy Spirit in Mother Mary inspired her to go to Jesus. Hallelujah. It was not the personal intention of Mother Mary. Mary was filled with the Holy Spirit. When did she receive the Holy Spirit, you know? We read about Jesus Christ while he was baptized in the river of Jordan. The Holy Spirit came upon to Jesus and he was filled with the Holy Spirit. That we read in the Bible, in the book of Matthew, chapter 3, verse 16 onwards. We read about that. How Christ received the Holy Spirit. But Mary, how she received the Holy Spirit? We read about it in the book of Luke, chapter 1, verse 35 onwards. There we read that the angel says to Mary that the Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Almighty will come upon you. When Mary said to the angel, Amen. Let it be according to your word. When Mary said Amen to the angel, immediately the Holy Spirit came upon to Mary and Mary was filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. See, so from that moment onwards, Mary was led by the Holy Spirit. She realized about that problem, that family, there is no wine. Immediately the Holy Spirit in Mother Mary inspired Mary to go to Jesus. And you know, Jesus came from the wilderness. After receiving the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God led him to the wilderness for the fasting prayer of 40 days. And Jesus was there for 40 days. And we read the same book, after the prayer, Jesus was filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. And with that power, he returned to Galilee. And this Cana is in Galilee. So after some days, coming from the wilderness of his prayer, filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, he came for the wedding. So Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit, and Mother Mary was there with the filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit in Mary inspired her to go to Jesus and say, there is no wine. She said to Jesus, there is no wine. When Mary said to Jesus, there is no wine, he asked one question. Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come. He rejected that appeal. He says that, my hour has not yet come. But hearing the rejection, hearing the word of Jesus, Mary is not going back. She says to the servants, this is very important. His mother said to the servants, do whatever he tells you. See, Mary is not worried about what Jesus said. Actually, he was rejecting Mary's prayer. He was standing with the disciples. He called not as mother, he said woman. Actually, it was like hurting Mary. But Mary is not going back because she was led by the Holy Spirit. Immediately, Jesus says that, my hour has not yet come. She said to the servants, do whatever he tells you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, Mary is commanding to the servants, not to the family members, do whatever he tells you. When Mary said that word, like a fire, touched the Spirit of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit in Jesus Christ. Immediately everything changes. He says to the servants, fill the jars with the water. The same Jesus who said, my hour was not yet come, the same Jesus within seconds says to the servants, fill the jars with the water. What changed Jesus Christ? To do the miracle. The word that came from Mother Mary. First he said, my hour has not yet come. Remember, my dear brothers and sisters, for many months or many years, we may be praying to the Lord. Maybe for healing, maybe for deliverance, maybe for financial blessing, good job, whatever it is, you know your problems. Every times Jesus may have said, my hour has not yet come. The time has not yet come. But today, through Mary, we are going to ask to the Lord for the blessing. Hallelujah. Here, Jesus cannot reject your plea. He won't reject it, whatever it is. That is the promise. When Mary said to him, he rejected, my hour has not yet come. But immediately when Mary said one thing, do whatever he tells you. Jesus was awakened. The Holy Spirit in him was inspired by the word from that came from Mary. He realized the time has come. It is the time is here to do something. Because Mary said to the servants, do something. Do whatever he tells you. Do. Means you have to do something. Whatever he tells you to do. That word inspired the Holy Spirit in Jesus Christ. Awakened the Holy Spirit in Jesus Christ. Immediately he said to the same servants. So that means that it was revealed to Mary that Jesus will perform a miracle there. That is why Mary said to the servants, do whatever he tells you. It was revealed to Mary that Jesus will perform the first miracle. And Jesus says to the servants, fill the jars with water. And we read that they filled the jars, the six stone jars, water jars, they filled it with the water. When it was filled up to the brim, it is written there. When it was filled up to the brim, water changed. And Jesus says, draw it out and taste it. They came to know it is not water, it became wine. It is wine now, pure wine. This is the miracle that happened in Cana of Galilee. But brothers and sisters, really, that miracle was not performed by Jesus Christ. Then who performed that miracle there? The first miracle of Jesus Christ. See, God used Mary for the miracle. And it was the miracle of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit in Jesus and the Holy Spirit in Mother Mary came together, doing together. They performed the first miracle there. It is very important that every time we come to Mary for our needs. But remember, the Holy Spirit in us, every time he is asking us to make sure that the presence of Mary is there in your heart. If Mary is there, he will tell you one thing, obey the word. That is what she said to the servants, do whatever he tells you to do. That means that obey the word. Obey the word. What is the word? In book of John 6:63, Jesus says that the words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. That is the word. He says that the words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. Say loudly, spirit and life. The word of God. That is the word of God. Spirit and life. What is the spirit? Spirit means Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Life means the life of God. When you hear the word, you are receiving the Holy Spirit and the life of God. Hallelujah. That is the word of God.
Awful need before you, as I bow my head in prayer, take this lay, make it yours, and fill me with your love. Lift your right hands. Ave Maria. all I have I give you. Every dream and wish I you, Mother of Christ.